important. Next, we have concept of polyhedrons. Now, there are two type of polyhedrons, prism and pyramid. Before moving on to that, what are polyhedrons? The figures who have straight surfaces, plane straight surfaces, are polyhedrons. This cannot be termed as a polyhedron because this is a curved part. Like for this marker as well, this is a curved part, so this cannot be a polyhedron. This is a polyhedron because all the surfaces are straight. Okay, so all these 3D figures, these are called 3D figures. If I talk about this normal rectangle, it is a 2D figure, and this cuboid is a 3D figure. Okay, so 3D figures with straight surface area, straight faces, are called polyhedrons, and the curved one are not called polyhedrons. Now there are two type of polyhedrons, prism and pyramid. Pyramid means the vertical is a single vertex, and here we can have a whole face or a whole line. So the figures with a pointed vertex is called a pyramid. So this is a prism. Upar ka straight surface ho sakta hai, ya like this, if we form a straight line in middle, this is also a prism. But if we talk about diamonds, जो ऊपर से एकदम pointed होते हैं, the pointed things are called pyramid. Now we have a concept regarding polyhedrons, which is called Euler's formula. Which says F plus V equals to E plus 2. Now what is F, V and E? F is number of faces, V is number of vertices, and E is number of edges. Now what is F, V and E? Faces means this place surface area, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. These are number of faces. What is vertices? The corner points, vertexes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. These are called vertices. And edges is the sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So edges are the sides, faces is this whole part, and vertices is the exact point. Now this is the formula for any polyhedron, any type of polyhedron, be it prism or a pyramid. F plus V, that is number of faces plus number of vertices, is always equal to number of edges plus 2. Okay? To get a 1 mark sum regarding this formula, you will be given F, V, V or E, either of 2, and we have to find remaining 1. Next exercise 6.3, we will be doing sums related to polyhedrons, which we have done in earlier lecture. Now, which are the polyhedrons from the following? Now, you know what are polyhedrons? Surfaces which have edges. Okay? So, figures like cylinder, cone cannot be termed as polyhedrons. First one is nail. Nail, as you all know, has a round shape, so it is not a polyhedron. Second is an unsharpened pencil. Unsharpened pencil, usually pencils have edges. This is a plane surface, this is a plane surface, and it has edges all over. So it is a polyhedron. Whereas a sharpened pencil has a round surface area over here, curved part, so it cannot be a polyhedron. Unsharpened pencil is a polyhedron. Because it has edges, it does not have any round curved surface area. This has a curved surface area. When you sharpen a pencil, it becomes curved. So it is not a polyhedron. So they have mentioned specifically unsharpened pencil. It is a polyhedron. Tile, you can make it out from the diagram itself. It is a polyhedron. Diamond also, you can make it out. It has edges. So again, it is a polyhedron. Mm-hmm. And fifth one, you can make out test tube has round shape in curved surface area in between. So it is not a polyhedron. Now question 2, relating to Euler's formula we have done earlier. V plus F equals to 2 plus E. So it's a very simple formula based sum and a 1 mark sum which you get in exam. V plus F equals to E plus 2. This is Euler's formula. We are given E is 30 and F is 12. We do not know V. So V equals to
20.
32 minus 12. Therefore V equals to 20. That is number of vertices is 20. Now if this solid figure is a prism, then how many sides the base polygon has?
10.
Now prism means there is a flat surface area both above and below. So it's simple. The number of vertices on the top and on the base will be same because prism is flat from above. So for example, if you take cuboid, how many vertices it has? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what is the question we are asked? How many sides the base polygon has? Now identify how many sides the base of this quadrilateral has. 4. How do you get 4? Dividing by 2 the number of vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Usually the number of vertices and the number of sides will be same. Upar char side hai aur char vertices hai. So now we know what is the number of vertices. 20. Matlab 10 vertices upar hai aur 10 vertices niche hai. To upar bhi 10 sides hai, niche bhi 10 sides hai. So niche sides kitni hogi? 20 sides. Therefore number of sides in base is 10 divided by 2. Next question 3. First we'll do question 4 and question 5. They are same as question 2. We are given F is 14, V is 24, and we are going to find out E. So again we'll start the sum directly by Euler's formula. V plus F equals to E plus 2. What is your V? 24. F is 14. E plus 2. Put therefore sign. Therefore E equals to 36. For a solid, now we are given V and E is 18. So again, F plus V equals to E plus 2. V is 10, E is 18. F equals to 20 minus 10, that is F equals to 10. Question 4, question 5. Next question 3. We are given certain polyhedrons and we are required to verify Euler's formula. That is, you have to prove that F plus V is equal to E plus 2. And definitely it will always be equal. So your first diagram is this. We have to find out F, V and E. Okay? So F is the number of faces. Faces kitne hai? There is one in the top and one in the base. And how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So vertical there will be 6 faces. This vertical, 6 faces. One top and one base. So 6 plus 1 plus 1, that is 8. Then number of vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 on the top and 6 in the base. So 6 plus 6, 12. Next is E. Number of edges means sides. So there are 6 sides in the top, 6 sides in the base. एंड सिक्स सेम वर्टिकल साइड्स. ये चार दिख रहे हैं तुम्हें और दो यहाँ से इमर्ज होंगे. सो सिक्स साइड्स, सिक्स प्लस सिक्स प्लस सिक्स, 18. नाउ वी विल वेरीफाई LHS separately and RHS separately because you are asked to verify, not find out the either of the value. So what is LHS? F plus V. 8 plus 12 which is 20. And RHS E plus 2. So 18 plus 2, 20. So since LHS equals to RHS, hence true. And definitely always LHS and RHS will be equal because Euler's formula is valid for all the type of polyhedrons. All the three sums will be done in same pattern.